back to the Lion's Den, everybody. This is Panzer King here. Today I bring you a new series called The Secrets of the Lion's Den. And basically, what this series is going to be about is it's going to be about unique ideas I've come up with, different ways of doing your board gaming, specifically with Global War 36, and a few other games, and just showing you what my ideas have been and what I've invented, created, but also what ideas I've learned from other videos and passing it on, because by all means, I'm sure a lot of these ideas that I've come up with or think I've come up with are ideas that have probably been around for a while. Anyways, what you see in front of you here is a letter from Matt Todd. He sent me this, and he actually sent me some planes. And you can see in front of you there, he sent me some Japanese Zeros, some Val dive bombers, and some Betty bombers. And basically, he wants me to show him how I painted my Zeros. And for those who don't know how my Zeros have turned out, and as well as my other Japanese planes, rather than painting them just the standard orange, I actually painted them green and white. And this is one of the rare exceptions in this game where rather than painting all the planes and land units and ships the same color as the color that we picked for each nation, I decided I wanted to give a bit of historical accuracy. And you can see right here, you can see the Zeros with their green color and their white color, probably predominantly from a lot of old war movies and documentaries, but my favorite was the Battle of Midway with Charlton Heston. And also Tora Tora Tora, if any of you also remember that. That was a great movie too. Anyways, I just wanted to give a little bit of flavor, a little bit of change. And what I did was I kind of had a system in mind where I was going to make the white planes the Navy planes and the green planes the Japanese Army planes. Because at that time, the Army and the Navy were two separate organizations, I guess you can say. And they had their own separate air forces, for lack of a better word. But ultimately, it's kind of fun just to mix and match some of the fighters and bombers on top of the carriers just to make it look a little bit more real. But that being said, what I did was I figured, well, I want to be accurate. So I painted the Zeros with yellow on the tips of the wings there and in the fuselage. And the Val dive bombers were white, but these were already white, so I didn't really do too much there. And then the Betty bombers I just painted red. But I made all the engines black, which is kind of historically accurate. And that's actually probably one of my favorite things are the green Zeros, just because they do stand out like nothing that you see before in this game. And that's where my favorite thing is just to give it a bit of artistic license, but a bit of historical accuracy as well. But the problem was, I was actually going to change all of these planes that you see before you to a different color scheme, but I've actually probably decided against that. I'm actually going to keep my Zeros and maybe my Vals painted this yellow just as a Japanese exception. Because some of you may or may not know, I'm actually designing a color coding system for all my planes. And you can see here, and I'll give you a little zoom in, this is my color code system for what I want for all the planes. Transports, as probably most of you would assume, would be white. I put in an Italian seaplane here, but the seaplane's tips would all be blue to represent the water. But I did, the fighters were originally yellow, like the Zeros were, for this German Bf 109, but I decided to paint it green. And the tactical bomber would be part of a series of bombers. And you can see here, being that it's a bomber, yellow, it's the lightest. Orange, you're getting a little bit hotter, a little bit more payload, medium bomber. And then of course you get up to the heavy bomber or the strategic bomber, however you want to phrase it, with the red. And then of course the purple, which can also be symbolized as a very hot color too, depending how you look at it, as the heavy strategic bomber. So you can see those three, or actually four, bombers that have that color code there. But I didn't stop there. For the jets, I also wanted to do one more thing. And I decided to give it a bronze, silver, gold coloring. So you see the ME-262 there. It is bronze, or copper, however you want to look at it. the Horton 229, which was a fighter that never really made it into service. It's also more of a tactical fighter bomber, but anyways, it's bronze, so I use them as my fighters for Germany. And then if and ever what happens if you play East versus West or the America game, I kind of designed some of these other planes right here. The 555, as I call it here, and the Horton, I think it's 18, HO-18 bomber, is my tactical bomber, and of course my heavy bomber. So I've just given that bit of free rein there, but I just like the order and the symmetry and the color coding. This way you can know instantly what that is. But it's a bit of a distraction here, but I wanted to show you why I was changing the colors. But actually with the Japanese, I think I'm actually gonna keep them this color right here, just for fun. The one exception in the game, and obviously if you're a Japanese player, you're gonna know what a fighter is and what a Val bomber is, right? But that being said, this is what we're gonna create here in this video. I'm gonna try to make it as short as possible, but I also wanna just show you how I created these, how I painted these. And with the set that was given to me by Matt Todd, which was very nice, you see I actually put Field Marshal flight stands on top of these fighters because the magnets he uses are actually far smaller than the ones I have. And of course, they don't actually fit my flight stands because they reverse polarity. So I just use these here. These are actually general hand grenades. I just had a few of them lying about here just to show you what I'm going to do with them. And we'll probably go to my workshop in town, and that's where I'll show you the next step and show you step by step how these get painted, deckled, and ultimately finished. So we'll see you in a bit. Hey guys, now we're back at the workshop here, and I'm going to show you how I paint these. Now, Matt Todd, he suggested, actually he wanted the Zeros and the Vals painted white and the Betty Bombers to be painted green. Now what I use for those colors is I use the Racing Green. This is the Tamiya color stuff that you can get at most hobby shops, TS-43. I found that seemed to be the best green. But then I also realized, rather than using a lot of theirs, because it is expensive, like right here, we paid $12.99 Canadian just for this small can, and I actually pay less for that, for this big can that you can get at Home Depot. And this one right here is a gloss white, which I think looks really good. So if you can find a suitable color for these ones, Home Depot is always a good selection to go for cost effectiveness, and you get a lot more sprays out of a bigger can than these smaller ones. The downfall between that is this particular can, you'll probably get 15 minutes and this will be dried. This, I find sometimes you gotta let the whole day just for it to set, but if you put it out in the sun, it gets lots of heat, then it's not too bad. And what I do is that I find that this white stuff here, this white paint, actually comes with a primer in it and also bonds to plastic. So I actually never really did much with primer when it came to these big cans. And basically you just spray just a light coat, not too much, and then just let it set. It's a bit of a tedious process, but of course once it's done, then obviously what we're gonna do is we're gonna come back, flip these guys over, paint the underside, then I'll flip them back again, paint them, and sometimes I'll even do the fourth time, which will be the undercoat for the undersides, and that'll ultimately end up giving it the nice finish that I want. And then of course these guys here, using this can, it doesn't take much, just a little bit of spray. I didn't put any primer on it because I found sometimes primer, it's kind of a pain in the butt, even though it should be good when it comes to actually prepping the surface, but some primer I put on actually ruined it because it just wasn't shaken well enough, or it just didn't adhere properly, and then it still scraped off when you use your fingernail. So I just actually like and believe in just using this, and then after all this is done, it's painted, it's labeled, you can put a clear coat on it, and then usually that should be good, because it doesn't matter what you do. If you're pretty abusive with these little models, I mean, it's gonna scrape, it's gonna scratch, it's gonna scar to begin with, right? But it just depends how you handle them. And ultimately, long term, it should last quite well. So anyways, I'll come back to you guys when we have a little bit more progress on the painting here.
And welcome back, guys. I'm at my desk here at my workshop in town, and I'm just going over how we're gonna paint these beauties. You can see here, we ended up painting these several times on both sides. Rather than showing a video of it, it was just easier just to do it. And then, of course, you can see now how it's all painted. You can see down here just a little bit of the blemishing where Matt put the his magnets in, which are a little bit smaller than my magnets. But I think they turned out really good. I like the green. I love the white zeros too, but I've always been a big fan of the green ones, or the green color. And as I said before, that was the racing green color that I used. I think it's one of the better ones. And then of course, just a standard white gloss. So anyways, but it's so simple to do this. It just takes a bit of patience, obviously, right? So basically what I do, and it doesn't matter what you do, you can paint or decal first, but usually I decal. Here are the decals I've been using. You know, these are obviously larger ones and smaller ones and whatnot, and ones you can get from historical board gaming that I cut out and just dip them into a bit of water here. And you use some very fine tweezers in order to just peel them off. Usually dip them into the water. I usually cut out a section of two or three or however many I want to put on, hold them, put it into the water for, you know, 10 seconds, not even that. And usually it's really hot water. And then of course you just take them off and then you carefully apply them onto the plane. Now, I cheated a bit here. I actually did that before this because I wanted to show you how to do it because it's so hard to do it in front of the camera. So what I did is a few minutes ago, I just finished up this zero. And like I say, it didn't take very long at all. You can see here, I painted some yellow in the front there, the black nose, and then just dotted the wings with some decals there. So that turned out pretty good. And it's a lot better than I find your standard orange plane if you're a Japanese player, or yellow plane, or just having a standard color. But my favorites are the Val Dive Bombers. This one I did a little bit different. I actually swooped the black towards the canopy of the cockpit there. And then of course I just put the decals down. It's kind of hard to see, it's a little bit blurry, but I think it actually looked really good. And I also then just dotted the wheels too, just a bit here. Sometimes less is more. You don't want to do a lot or go painting the tips or whatever. I think it's fun to have a bit of historical accuracy when you're dealing with these guys. So I think sometimes, as I say, like less is just more. If you've got a lot of planes and you're doing a paint code, well, that's a different story, right? And then over here, the last one here is the Betty Bomber. I've just put it on the end of this these here. And of course, I painted the yellow tips in the front, and then did the black engines again, kind of the hallmark of it as well. But I also had some fun and I put white decals on there because some of the Betty Bombers actually had that. Some of them just had white decals, but you can see here on this, it actually turned out pretty darn good. And then of course it would just go on the flight stands once you have that done. So yeah, ultimately simple, easy. You know, to do these three planes, it took me 10 minutes, right? You know, it just depends on the level of patience and how quickly you need to do it or want to do it, and you know, how accurate you are. And as far as brushes for painting, I got these three brushes 3 years ago and I'm still using them. They're absolutely amazing. They are the Superstar ones that I think you get probably at most hobby stores. They're made in Germany, of course. You just gotta make sure you clean them at the end of the day. You know, they're probably about 10 bucks a brush, but it's nice because then you got the ultra fine for, you know, maybe painting the tails or something like that, or some stripes, and then just bigger ones for dotting the ships or whatever, right? But you can see they've got some use there, but super simple, right? And that's all you need. I just grab a few of these brushes and boom, you're done. And then of course the paint is the black X1. I like the gloss for that. And then for the Zero and the Betty Bomber here, I used the lemon yellow. And to explain why I did that, I'll show you over here. You can see here are the zeros, and I went with a similar paint job for some of them. One thing you can see with the green zeros, and that's why they're my favorite, is you can see the yellow on the actual wings. That's what I kind of did for the white zeros. But yeah, very simple and less is more. Betty Bomber here. I tried to copy that little that white flag there and just the yellow across the wings there. It's a little bit harder when you got the two engine bombers here. Sometimes tipping the wings is nicer, but you don't see anything tipped on these planes. And if you're going for that accuracy, you definitely want to make it happen. And then of course over here, my favorite is the Val Dive Bomber. Very sleek, but you can see right here the swooped back look with the paint. And I did that. I actually didn't even do that for mine. I just decided, okay, let's do something a little bit different here. So I figured that we'd change that up a bit and make it look good. So yeah, like I say, you can see here, it's just the black, the red dots and the tires. Once again, just nice, simple, basic look, nothing too much, right? So anyways, but yeah, anyways, I'll let you guys get back to whatever you're doing on this fine day. And hopefully this helped you guys do your own models. But at the end of the day, you just gotta dive right in, experiment. I've repainted many planes, many models, because I wasn't happy with them, or I was just like, you know, I don't like that. No, let's do something different here. And ultimately, that's how the game goes. Anyways, this is Panzer King here in Prince George, British Columbia, here at my workshop, just showing you how to make the Japanese planes. Take care, everyone, and have a good one. Hey guys, just back here quickly just to show you the final product. I was able to find some flight stands that actually had the reverse polarity on it. And you can see they are done now. So Matt, these are going to be shipped out to you sometime today or tomorrow. And I hope you enjoy them. I had a little bit of fun with them, made them kind of historically accurate as best as possible with some of the markings there. The Val Dive Bombers, even though they are super simple, I like them the best. And like I say, sometimes less is more. And ultimately, you can always paint the tips or whatever you want to do for a color code. But I like, sometimes I just like having them like this, because I think the Japanese Zeros, the Vals, the Kates, the Betty Bombers were the most iconic, some of the most iconic planes in World War II, just because of the color scheme and some of the great movies like Midway, Tora Tora Tora, and others that were all popularized the Japanese Air Force in the Second World War. So anyways, I just wanted to show you that finally as a quick little video so you can see how they looked out, and hope to hear from your comments and see what you guys think, and from there we'll just see you guys later. This is Panzer King from the Lion's Den, out.